start to sit comfortably. Now you can sit up on blankets if you choose to. And just close your eyes.
Let yourself start to be with your breath. Accepting your breaths in and out easily.
Just feeling the breath coming into your belly. Enjoy feeling that movement through the belly if you're comfortable to come into those three-part breaths. Gradually make your way from your belly through your ribs up to your chest if that feels good. Exhale, go ahead and let your hands come on out beside you, lightly touching the floor here. And we'll inhale both arms all the way out and up overhead. And let our exhale bring our hands right down to be in front of our hearts. And then we'll reverse and inhale the hands right up through the midline. And on the exhale, open the arms on back out and down. And now just let your right arm float up and bring it across your chest. Put your hand over, kind of loop your hand over your shoulder there, just so you can feel the weight of your hand there and the weight of your arm hanging with your hand just kind of pressing down into the top of your shoulder for a second. And then just tilt your head away from your hand. Let your right ear come towards your right shoulder so you can release there. Maybe a little deeper through that side of the neck. And you can even, if you want, kind of push with your fingers, push gently down into that muscle that might feel a little tight. And then we'll bring our head on back up, and we're going to go to the other side. So bring your left arm up and across, and go ahead and find that kind of really nice place to hang your arm there, so that when you do tilt your head away, it feels good. Let yourself just press maybe gently down with your fingertips a little bit, almost like you're giving yourself a massage. And then we'll rise to come on back up. And from here, release your arms on down. Let's come on into a seated forward bend. You know, it's totally up to you how far you go. You can come and put your hands on the floor in front of you and stay there. You can keep walking forward if you want. And remember, you can do what you want with your legs. You can have legs long, or you can have cross legs. Just back on that. So take your time, enjoy. Let yourself release through your face and your jaw. One more breath. And then slowly start to rise yourself all the way on back up. Take a nice inhale at the top. And on your exhale, twist to your right. Let yourself come on around to the right. Lengthening up through the top of your head. Enjoy finding that twist in the middle of the back. But just really imagine you're just waking your spine up a little bit here. And one more inhale there. And on the exhale, we're going to come to the twist the other direction. So let yourself come on around to your left and ease your way on up through the top of your head there. And one more inhale. And on your exhale, make your way on back into center again. Bring your hands behind you and let yourself just draw your chest forward, your shoulders back. And feel really good there to open up through the front of the body. Release to come back forward. Bow your head a little bit here. Let your chin come on down towards your chest. of you like to turn your head a little bit so your chin comes one way and the other. Do that. Really depends on you, how your neck feels. And then we'll come on back to center, rising the head up. And if you're cross-legged, we're going to switch to cross the leg. So you can stretch your leg out in between as you bring the other leg in front. Just take your time there. And this time, let's come forward and back with the breath. So let your exhales bring you forward, and your inhales bring you back up, keeping that nice long spine. So that sense of rocking forward and back with your breath. So enjoy. Feel length in the back of your neck and throat. Forward. We're going to stay forward. So again, you can put your hands there and support yourself and stay just up higher. You can keep on going if that feels really good to walk your hands out more. Just be easy. Feel your low back, getting that nice gentle stretch in your hips. And if you can, let your head hang loose so you let go through your face and your jaw. Ourselves on back up and release our arms on out beside us, and let's inhale the hands, arms all the way out and up overhead. Go ahead and clasp your hands, bend your elbows quite a bit here, and then press your hands a little forward, like a little higher than your face if you can, like a little higher than your head, but don't do it if your shoulders bother you, you can keep them low. And then just slowly start to see what happens if you start to rise your arms up. You can come all the way hands overhead if that's possible. Or you can stay forward with your hands. It really depends on your shoulders. And then lean a little bit over to the right so you come into that left side stretch there a little more. And then just come back to center and go the other way. So we're going to do that a couple more times. So it's kind of up to you as you come back and forth how far over you want to go. But keep pressing up into the heel of that hand of the side you're stretching. Right? So you really feel just a little bit more spaces between the ribs there that feels like they get bigger once you get into the side there, onto your side. So finish off, let yourself come on back in the center again. And just circle your arms back behind you if you can. And again, letting yourself bring your hands down and open through the chest. Nice, and then we'll rise on back up. And let's stretch our left leg out just a little beside us. Now you got to kind of adjust whatever feels good for your right leg here. So if you need to, you can have it long, because we're just going to come a little bit forward, trying to get into, if you have one leg out, it just seems to be a little more intense to isolate the inner thigh. So if you can just have one leg out, if you need to do both, go ahead. And then take your time. Come a little forward till you feel, it doesn't take long, but if you feel your inner thigh there, as soon as you start to even think about coming forward, you're like, oh, there's my inner thigh. So be mindful, take your time. Go as far as you want. If you're like, oh, well, it starts to feel better and I want to come down farther, you can if you want. Yeah. We're going to slowly make our way up because we're just going to switch legs. So again, you have to be mindful of what this one that's bent wants to do. And if your knee feels iffy, remember too, sometimes just support underneath it when you come forward will help you not feel a little glitch in your knee if you're feeling something or your hip, right? Or you can keep the leg long. But just enjoy finding that again. Here's your inner thigh. Just wake it up a little bit. Bring your breath to where you need it. So if you're going, oh my goodness gracious, in your inner thigh, then imagine you're breathing into it. By the way, we have a new little nest. The old ones flew away a long time ago. So now there's a new nest going here towards you, I think. Come on down. physical verbs up there. We'll bring our legs forward, circle our feet around a little bit. You can do little wiper blades if you want, little leg bounces if you want. We're going to come around towards our hands and knees. So grab what you need. You know that? If you do not want to be on your knees, don't be on your knees. Right? Use a blanket. If your hands bother you, you need to come onto fists to take away that wrist crease. You can do that. Or you can come down to your forearms if you like. You can move the pack kind of quite easily, actually, on your forearms. So just play around with your cat-cow where you're comfortable to be. Move at your own pace. If you feel like you want to switch when you've done a few and can change how you are on your hands, go to your forearms, or if you feel like you want to change a little bit when you get into one of the poses. Like sometimes if you get into cat pose, it feels good to shift forward and back a little bit when you're in the pose. So just let your body kind of find its own little adjustments, yes? You're back into a neutral spine again. And we'll send our right foot back behind us on the floor. Curl your toes under, press into your heel, and now zip up the belly. So you're really feeling the belly engaging there. And then we're going to switch legs. So just bring that left foot back, curl the toes under, and hinge the belly here. Press equally into your hands there. Shift back towards pose of a child. That doesn't mean you have to go all the way. You're more than welcome to come to your forearms and kind of be forward if that's too much on your knees to shift back. Let your arms be soft overhead for a couple of breaths if possible. Let yourself feel the breath coming into your low back. From here, we're going to come on back up and onto all fours so we can step our left foot forward to find our lunge here. So you know if you like your blocks under your hands, you can have your blocks, you can have your hands on the floor. Take your time, get into that alignment here in your lunge where you feel really good to be up into your hips. Feel that length through the back body. Find that alignment of the front knee where you're comfortable and know you're not overbending that front knee. Engage your belly, bring your shoulders down. Yeah. And now straighten the front knee out and let that right heel just descend directly behind your foot. Lift your left toes up so you can see that foot. Make sure you're not rolling on it. You're looking right down at it. And then let your toes come back down and let's bend the front knee and come on back into our lunge. Press the feet gently away from each other. And we're going to switch our legs. So it doesn't matter how you do that. You can step back, you can step forward, coming into the right leg forward. And again, just make sure you've got that alignment going where you're really comfortable and how deeply that front knee is bent and you're finding that length through the back body. Your head being as a part of your spine, too. Feel the feet gently pressing away from each other. We are going to straighten that right leg out and let that left heel descend directly back. You can even look back and make sure you're not hiking your heel inward. And then see if you can lift just your right toes up. See the whole four corners of the feet there on the mat. You can make sure you're not rolling to the inside or the outside of that foot. Toes come back down. We're going to bend the front knee, come back into that lunge. And let's step forward from here and come on into our standing forward bend. So you know how much support you use is totally up to you. Bring yourself easily into where you can stay and be with your breath and you don't feel discomfort in your back at all. So elbows above the knees can work, hands on the block. And you can even stack blocks up and put your forearms on your blocks, or even if you nod your head on blocks. So just be easy, enjoy letting the pose help the backs of the legs to naturally open up. And you know your knees can be bent. Let your weight feel kind of forward over your legs so that you're not feeling like you're shifting back with your hips. Good. One more breath. And then we'll bend our knees and let our hands float on up to our hips as we rise up to standing. And inhale our arms all the way out and up over our head. And on our exhale, let our hands come right down to the front of our hearts. So putting into mountain pose, take your time, adjust however you need to. Let your feet get just the right distance apart. Hands gently coming together in front of your chest. Bringing your gaze on forward and out. And let yourself be easy as you start to feel your feet in the floor and that strong base through your feet. But drawing up out of your rooted feet. So you feel your thighs gently lifting upward. And once your pelvis is aligned, just easily letting the body stack itself up. Enjoying your mountain pose here. Let the jaw release. If you feel like you're kind of gripping, you might even want to let your lips separate a little bit, your teeth separate, and feel like you're really letting go of any tension you might hold in your jaw. And then we'll release, unfold our arms right down beside us, and inhale both arms all the way out and up. And on the exhale, we'll bend our knees, coming forward into our standing forward bend. Let your next inhale help you find a nice, long, flat back wherever you want your hands to be. And we'll step our right foot back and come into lunge here. And inhale, exhale into your downward facing dog pose. So take your time, spread those fingers nice and wide, walk your dog a little bit. Be mindful of just giving the body a chance to work its way into down dog in a really easy way, right? So that it feels like then, once you get into dog and you feel that sense of the whole body in your dog, it becomes like a easy pose, right? We're going to come on out towards plank, engaging the belly here, reaching your sitting bones down towards your heels. And then to lower down, you can put your knees down first, it's fine, lowering all the way down to the floor. Let's come on into Sphinx, onto our forearms, as close to his elbows under the shoulders as you can be, but don't force it. Spread your fingers wide, bring your gaze there, onto the floor, so that you're not lifting your chin up and tensing the back of the neck, but it feels really nice and long. And then see if you can just put the tips of the right toes on the floor, and then lift the thigh and the knee up. You're straightening the leg out, and then put it back down, and come back to the top of your toes. And do the other side. So the left toes, you can curl them under if that's possible. And then think of lifting up the knee and the thigh just for a second. And then bring the thigh back down and let yourself come back to pointing your feet. Come halfway down to the floor with your upper body and slide your hands back by your chest. Your upper chest, hug your elbows in towards each other. And if you want to continue upward into a more of a cobra, you can, or you can stay right there where you are. That is a cobra pose where you are. But if you want to come up higher, you like that sense of coming up higher, you can. We'll return back down to the mat, and we're going to come back into down dog. So you can come through a half or a full push-up, or you can shift back your hands and knees and back to dog if you want. Walk your dog a little bit. Let yourself turn your head a little side to side too. Not in a way that feels stressful, but that's helping you feel release. So you might just want to look kind of to the side of the mat and then the other side. Or you might want to look under your arm when you turn your head. That's really up to you and how your own neck feels. And then we'll come on back into our full down dog. We'll bring our right foot forward back into lunge. And then we'll come on back into our standing forward bend. So as you come into Uttanasana, again, be mindful. Feel your sitting bones over your heels. Let yourself come to where you're able to be, whether it's holding your elbows or you want your elbows above your knees or you want to use your hands on blocks. Just enjoy feeling that sense of release for your back and your hips and the backs of your legs. Nice full deep breath. So wash those breaths down all the way through. So follow your breath all the way through your inhale and then all the way through your exhale. So you feel like your awareness can stay fully with your breath. Back up to our hips and press into our feet as we rise on up. And inhale our arms all the way out and up. And on our exhale, let our hands come down together in front of our hearts. Let's inhale our hands up just a little higher than our head. And then let your hands come right to the back of the top of your head. You're still in prayer hands. And it's kind of like you're just gently resting the hands right there towards the back of your head, though not right exactly on top. And then from there, let your chin rise up a little bit. Let your gaze come up a little bit. Feel your tailbone now still reaching down towards between your heels. So the elbows rise up, the gaze comes up, kind of supporting your head a little bit with your hands right there. One more breath. And then let your gaze come on back forward. We're going to extend our arms up and take your left hand and circle your right wrist here. Pull up a little bit. And then reach over into side stretch. So don't pull hard. You're just gently letting yourself feel a little more through that side stretch for the right side. And then we'll come back to the top and we're going to switch hands. So now just pull it up gently with your hand around your wrist there before you come over to the side. And then just enjoy breathing into the left side. Good. And then we'll come on back up again. Let your arms come into a wide V. Really feel your shoulders soften down. If you need to come even lower, what the arms do. So you just feel this tremendous sense of openness across your chest here. One more inhale. And on the exhale, we're going to fold forward into standing forward bend. And let your next inhale lengthen out your spine. And we're going to step our left foot back this time to come into lunge. And inhale. Exhale into your downward facing dog pose. Spread the fingers wide. You feel good about that. Good. We're going to come on out to plank. Let's do a little side plank. You can do the variation where you put your left knee down and you should use your foot like a kickstand and then bring your right hand to your right hip. Or you can do a full side plank if you choose, right? Find the one that works for you today. You can bring that foot up if you want, that right foot. If you're on your knee, you can let yourself stay there for a breath. And then we're going to come on back down, and we're going to switch. So take your time through plank, walk a little bit at first. Keep your hips up pretty high. Let yourself kind of walk a little bit in your plank. Let it feel good. And then we'll do the other side. So again, as you come onto the right hand, you're on your right knee if you're using your knee. And then you can stretch your arm up. Lift that left foot up, whether you're in a full one or on the knee. It's harder to lift up when you're in a full side plank, that's for sure. And then come on back down. Let's make our way back into plank from here. And we're going to lower down, knees first if you need, elbows right by the ribs. And we'll come into that cobra again. You can stay low. You can even float your hands up if you want. Or you can press into your hands and come up higher. Totally up to you, which one you need. Good. And then we'll release back down to the mat. Once you're there, bring your hands under your forehead. Let yourself just rest your head with your hands, just making that little pillow. Bend your right knee, flex the foot, pull the heel in towards your buttocks. And then see if you can float your head up off your hands. Just that, no more. And then come on back down with the leg and your head. And then bend your left knee, flex the foot. Really feel the heel drawing inward. Let your head float up again. You're actually kind of pressing into your forearms, giving yourself a little bit of help there. And then we're going to come back down with all of it. We're going to slide our hand back by our chest. And we're going to come back into down facing dog pose, however we choose to get there. Once you're in dog, bring your feet a little closer together. Lift your right leg up in the air. And then bend your knee and open the hip. You can look underneath your right arm if you want. Let yourself kind of stack the right hip on top of the left. And then put that one down, and we're going to go the other side. So left leg comes up. You can bend the knee and let yourself Really feel almost like you're stacking your left hip on top of your right. Look under your arm if you want. And then we're going to come on back down with that foot. Good. From here, we're going to bring our left foot forward and come into lunge. And then we'll come all the way back into our standing forward bend. So take your time. Use whatever support you need. See if you can allow yourself to release your head as much as possible. Let go through your face and watch those breaths again. So staying with your breath all the way in and all the way out. And then we'll let our hands come back up to our hips, bend our knees, press into our feet and rise up. And inhale our arms all the way out and up. And let our exhale bring our hands right down to be in front of our hearts. Come into your mountain pose here really easily. Feel that connection there through each of your fingers and your thumbs. Just spread your fingers out a little bit and really feel that light connection there at your hands. Feel the feet in the floor. We're going to move with the breath now. So really imagine the breath is what is carrying you easily through these next two sun salutations. So releasing your arms down beside you and inhaling the arms all the way out and up. And let your exhale carry you forward in standing forward bend. Inhale into that nice long spine. And exhale right foot back to lunge. And inhale. Exhale into down dog. Inhaling your way out to plank. Let your exhale lower you down. And inhale into your cobra of choice. And exhale back into down dog. Inhale. Exhale right foot forward to lunge. And inhale. Exhale to your standing forward bend. Bend the knees. Rise all the way to the top of your breath. And let the exhale be what carries you forward. Inhale. Nice long spine. Exhale, left foot back to lunge. And inhale. Exhale into down dog. Inhale out to that plank. And exhaling as you lower. Inhale into your cobra. And exhale back to down dog. Inhale. Exhale, left foot forward to lunge. And inhale. Exhale into standing forward bend. Bend the knees, rising to the top of your breath. And let your exhales bring you forward again. Inhale, nice long back. We're going to come into down dog, however you want to get there. Take your time, jump or walk. Get yourself established there in your down dog. Do what you feel good to do. Wag your tail. Walk yourself a little bit around. Let your head release. Nice. And from here, we're going to bring our left foot forward. We're coming up for warrior two, and you might want both your blocks handy here. Line up your heels. Let yourself really enjoy coming into that alignment in your warrior two. And then look down at your knee. Let your hands just be wherever's comfortable. Look down at your knee and then just let yourself bend and straighten the knee a few times, right? It doesn't have to go all the way straight, but just that idea of feeling how the knee is lining up with the center of the foot. Feeling your quad engaging. When you bend that knee, think of your outer left hip dropping down. You can even put your thumb there and kind of encourage that kind of downward motion in the outer hip. And then come on into your full warrior two legs there. Bring your hands to meet in front of your chest, in front of your heart. And then let's inhale the hands up through the midline. Once you get up there, turn the palms away from each other first. And then lower the arms on down. But imagine you're reaching farther and farther away from yourself as you do. Turning your gaze to look over the top of your left hand when you're there. And just enjoy feeling that sense. Almost like you're as wide as you can be. Feel really very good about how your tailbone is in this pose, right? You don't want to tuck it up under you. Kind of reach it back and down a little bit. Good. We're going to turn the left palm up and fold the right arm behind us if we can. And inhale, reach up towards the sky. Breathing into the left side. Let yourself just enjoy the breath, expanding the ribs on that side. One more inhale. And on your exhale, come on into your side angle. So let your hand, your right hand, stay behind you for a second. Go ahead and bring your hand or your forearm to your thigh. Look down at your left foot. Good. And then start to open that right shoulder towards the ceiling. We're going to trail the right hand up. Just trail it along the right side of your body. All the way by your ear. And then all the way up. If this doesn't hurt your shoulder, you know that. So coming into that extended side angle now. Letting yourself feel that outer left hip drawing back still. Good. One more breath. Now turn to look at the floor. And we're going to come into lunge. So you may want to grab your blocks, right? You're going to let yourself release that right heel directly behind you. And we're going to, from here, keep our right hand grounded and turn to look left and rise that left arm up if you can. Because we're going to move a little in the twist. So we're going to look at the floor, swing that left arm down in front of our left shin. And then when we inhale, come back up with the arm into your twist. So exhaling, looking at the floor, letting the arm come down. And as you inhale, swing it on back up. And then one more time, exhaling as you look down. And inhaling when you come back up. Stay here for a breath. Now, if you decide you want to cross over with that right elbow to your left knee and come into twisted prayer here, you can. Or you can keep your right hand down, keep your hand either on your low back or rise your arm up. One more breath here. And then we're going to come back into lunge. From there, straighten your left knee out. And let yourself, if you can, lift up the heel of your left foot. So your right heel descends even more towards the ground. And you're getting in pretty deeply into the back of that left leg too. And from here, we're going to bring the left foot all the way down, bend the front knee, come back to lunge. And we're going to make our way back into downward facing dog pose from here. Walk to the tops of the feet a little bit. It usually feels really good. Pressing into the top of the toes on one foot at a time to give your feet time to release after those. Good. And then let your feet come a little closer together. Bring your right leg up in the air into three legs. And then for a couple of times, we're going to come forward like we're going to do a plank and bring our knee in and down towards the floor a little bit. And then we're going to stretch back into that three-legged dog. So coming forward, letting the knee come down or in towards your chest if you want. And then inhale as you stretch it back. And one more time, exhaling as we come in. And inhaling when we come back. We're going to put that foot down. We're going to switch legs. Three-legged left leg up. And then we're going to come on forward with that knee. And inhale when you stretch back. So exhaling as you come down, forward. And inhaling when you come back. We'll do one more. Exhaling as we come. And then inhaling as we reach back. Put the foot down. We're going to lower our knees down and come into child's pose. So you know you can keep your hips up if you need. If you're okay to bend your elbows and put your hands on your upper back, you can do that. If that feels really good for your arms, especially for your triceps. And if that doesn't feel good, keep your arms wherever you choose, okay? And just breathe into your low back. Good. Fun to get the heart rate up. And then come on back. Let's come forward with our arms again, but walk them over to the right. But don't go as far as you usually do. Go just to a place where you're like, oh, I can just release here and breathe. And then come on back to center and just go, again, not as far as you usually go when you're trying to, like, get yourself into a side stretch. Instead, just go over a little bit and then just stay and breathe. Might feel good. Nice. And then we'll come on back into center for one more breath. Good. And then from here, we're going to stretch our arms back long overhead. And we're going to curl our toes under as we come forward and come back into downward facing dog pose. Walk your dog a little bit. If you want to do a vinyasa or two, you're more than welcome to do a kriya or vinyasa. You can come out to your plank, move through to up dog if you want to or not. And then go ahead and meet back in down dog because we are going to bring our right foot forward and we're coming up for warrior two on the other side. So again, you might want your blocks handy. Take your time. Get yourself Again, we're going to kind of straighten and bend that front knee a few times just to, again, try to find that sense of that outward, that dropping down of your outer hip, right? So that that lines the knee up with the center of the foot. It doesn't matter how deeply the knee is bending, right? You just don't want it to bend in that way. You want it to go out over the, towards the center of your foot. And then get yourself established where you're going to stay. Bring your hands to be in front of your heart. Let yourself be mindful there. Feel very centered. And as we rise the hands up through the midline, stay up there. Turn the palms away from each other before you start to lower down. And now as they lower down, imagine you're reaching farther and farther and farther away from you. So that when you come to looking out over the top of that right hand, you feel almost as wide as you can be. Very strong, oriented. Take your time to get your feet in the floor. One more breath. And if you're able to fold your left arm behind you, do, or put your hand on your leg, turn your right palm up and inhale. Now stay here for a couple of breaths. Really feel the ribs expanding as you inhale. You know, if your neck bothers you, you don't have to look up. You can kind of look forward. You can even look down and back a little bit if that feels good. I like to play with the placement of the head in this sometime. So one more breath. Oh, okay, my back foot is kind of fun. And then when you exhale, come on into your side angle. So again, you can put your hand or your forearm on your thigh. Keep your left hand back for a second. Look down at your right foot. And then press into your hand or your forearm to open that left shoulder to now where you're in that long line through both sides of the body. Put your left hand down so it can trail up the side of the body. So you're just kind of letting yourself experience extending your arm up. And imagine you're extending all the way from the outside of that left heel all the way up through the fingertips here, right? And enjoy feeling your shoulders down away from your ears. Beautiful. Nice. So one more breath. Such a great pose. And then when you're ready to look at the floor, we're going to come down. Again, you might want your blocks under your hands. Find that lunge where you're releasing that heel. You might have to adjust your stance. And we're going to do that little moving through with a twist, right? So as you start to look to the right, bring your right arm on up. If you can do this with your hand on your shoulder if you want. And then start to look at the floor and swing the arm down if you're using it, or just let your shoulder come down. And when you inhale, come back into that twist with the arm either down or up. So exhaling, looking down, letting yourself come there. And then inhaling as you come back into the twist. And one more time, exhaling as you look down, swinging the arm down. Inhale, come back into the twist. And now, from here, you're welcome to go into that twisted prayer if you want. You can come down, readjust, bring your left elbow over to that right knee. Bring your hands, into prayer hands if you want. Or you can keep yourself into that twist with your hand on the block. Good. One more breath. And we're going to come on back down with our heels. We're going to straighten that front knee out. Remember, let the left heel descend and pick the right foot up to be on your heel if you can. Extend your torso out over that front leg. So you're getting into the hamstring. Big time. Oh, both of them. Good. Back leg maybe more than calf. And then go ahead and bend the front knee. Let yourself come on into your lunge. We're making our way back into downward facing dog. Yay for dog. So this time you're on your own. What feels good? Do you need to walk through to the tops of your feet again? Do you need to come into child's pose? Would you like to just, you know, play around in your dog? Three legs or, you know, oh, you can do those little belly circles. Maybe that would feel good in your dog. Or maybe you want to rest in child's pose, right? So don't push through. Let yourself kind of enjoy what you're doing, right? Let it be something that you want to do. Not something that causes you to feel discomfort. Good. We're going to meet back in down dog. Take your time, let yourself, if you're doing two sides, even yourself out, come down, come on back into dog. And we'll bring our left foot forward. This time we're coming up for warrior one, so you might want to adjust the back foot. You might want your quad handed to on this one. Bringing yourself on up, and as you bend into that front knee, take a look at how You have that knee over the center of the foot, but also have deep leader bending. Make sure you can see your toes. Excuse me. And then bring your gaze forward. Let your arms hang. Let it feel pretty good. Now, we're going to start to move the arms a little bit. We're going to try to think about staying very strong in the toes right here, in the belly, in the low back, in the hips. So first we'll start with the right arm. We're going to try to circle it, bringing it forward and out and up. And feel what happens when it comes up, and then when it goes back, what happens. How you feel even more lift in the belly and more openness in the front of that hip. We're going to do the other arm, inhaling the left arm up and back behind you. And again, feel what your belly does when these arms do this, right? And now both arms are going to inhale up and circle back behind us if we can. And then this time when they come forward and down, bring your hands to your heart and start to rise the hands up to the midline. Clasp your hands, send your pointer finger up. You can stay right here with your elbows bent. You don't have to even bring the elbows up or look up if you don't want. You know, if you want to straighten your arms out because it feels good in your shoulders, they can come forward. Or if you feel better to separate your hands, you know, go ahead and separate your hands. So let yourself enjoy coming into this very, very balanced and very strong in the core body, Warrior One. Good. One more breath. And then as your gaze comes forward, let your hands come gently down through the midline and get them right back to be together in front of your chest. And then we'll unfold our arms. We're going to turn sideways on our mat, coming into a wide-legged forward bend. So kind of adjust your stance. And then when you're ready, come on forward. If you like your blocks, by all means, get your blocks. Bend a knee at a time if you'd like to. Let yourself adjust your way into the pose easily. Good. And then come back to center. Turn your toes out, right? So now it's like bend both your knees like you did goddess, but you can support yourself here with your hands so that you let your back stay long. And then you can do that same thing. You can bend a knee at a time. Some of you I know, when you come into a straight leg on the side of the straight leg, you just want to lift up to your heels. So if that feels good, you can. And I know some of you like to shift over and then put your hands on the floor and shift your hips way down. So if that feels good, you can do that one, right? Totally up to you. Not necessary to do those at all. And then come on back into center so we can turn our toes back where our feet are parallel again. And then set yourself up. Maybe you want to use your blocks underneath your forearms out there in front of you. Maybe you don't. Maybe you want to go ahead and let your head hang down and let your hands come back towards between your feet. Every day is a new day, so today might not be the same as yesterday was or the day before. So, you know, just let yourself find that place where you can release in the upper body. Whatever support you need, and let yourself accept those full deep breaths all the way in and all the way out. And when you exhale, just imagine letting your face get softer and softer. Every time you exhale, just think about releasing a little more. And then we're going to let ourselves start to walk our hands on out so we can walk back to our left foot. So you can, you know, take your blocks with you if you want, leave them where they are, it doesn't matter. Come back into your lunge and then make your way back into your downward facing dog pose. And pick one foot up at a time and just circle the foot around. So you're just picking one foot up, your foot's circling. You can push down into the top of the toes too if you want on the floor. Just so you feel your feet, your ankles a little bit. And then you're on your own again. So if you like to do either coming out to plank and back to dog without back bending, or coming out to plank and going into your up dog straight from your plank, or coming through that chaturanga, through the push-up to come into an upward facing dog or another kind of back bend. You can be on forearms, sphinx. Take your time. If you're doing two sides, finish off so you're even, so that we can come back into downward facing dog pose again. And this time we'll bring our right foot forward and come up for warrior one on the other side. So again, as you rise your way up into warrior one, and let your gaze come forward. First, you know, make sure that front knee is bent really where you feel good about, and then find that angle of that back foot where you feel really good about squaring your shoulders, but opening through the front of the hip. So bringing your shoulders around square to the front of the mat. Feel that back foot on the floor, right? Think about your arches of both feet lifting up. And already, man, there's a big opening right here in the front of that left hip. Now when you start to bring your left arm up and overhead and back behind you, even more happens, right? Letting it release back down, but keeping that you can feel how the belly doesn't stop working. We'll go the other side. Right arm comes out and up overhead, and then as far as back behind you as you can. And if you can do one big arm circle, do it. If your shoulders are saying, just don't do it. And then this time when the arms come down and they come in to hands to the heart, we're going to inhale the hands right on up. Clasp your hands. You can keep your elbows bent. Send your pointer finger up. You can stay forward. You can look up if you want. You can bring the arms by your ears if you choose. You can open the hands if that feels better in the shoulders. Just feeling that focus of your warrior one here. Feel that core strength through the belly, the hips, the low back. Good. One more breath here. And then let your gaze come forward. Let your hands come on back down to be in front of the heart again. And we'll unfold our arms. We're going to turn again sideways, right? Coming into that wide-legged forward bend. So grab your blocks if you want them. This time, once we get our hands down, we're going to walk over towards our right foot. Whether you shift your block to the right or walk all the way over to hold on to the outside of your foot or your ankle. Once you're there, if you can bring your right hand to your right hip, do. And if you want to roll your shoulder up, you can. Totally up to you. You can just stay with the hand there without rolling the shoulder up or looking up. And then come on back through center. We're going to walk over to the other side. So again, once you get over there, as far as you want to go, bring your left hand up. And you can stay right there. You can roll the shoulder up, kind of look up if you choose to. And then we'll release and come back down with the hand. We're going to walk on back into center. And go ahead and adjust yourself, bend a knee at a time. And then bend both your knees. Let your elbows come to be right above your knees so that you bend them quite as deeply as you can, really, so that you're in a squat here, reaching back through your tailbone. So you have a nice flat back. So think about keeping your spine nice and lengthened here. So if you feel like you're rounding up into the middle of the upper back, imagine you're flattening that out as much as possible, right? As much as your back allows you to do that. Nice. And then we're going to release, and you are going to find again the place you want to be. I mean, maybe you want to walk your hands back behind you, let your head hang, and let yourself release that way. Maybe you need to keep supported so your back is long, support in front of yourself with blocks under your forearms or even your head. Or you can hold your ankles or bring your hands between your feet. And now, let's follow the breath again, all the way in and all the way out. Feeling those little spaces between your breaths. So take time to appreciate that little space at the end of your inhale before you exhale. And the little space at the end of your exhale before you inhale. Let yourself release a little deeper in those little spaces between your breaths. nice full deep breath. And we are going to walk back over towards our right foot and make our way back to lunge and then back into your downward facing dog pose. Again, finish off whatever you want to do for these last few seconds of either vinyasas or kriyas or putting your knees down or staying in dog or, you know, whatever feels good. Take your time. Nice. And then we'll meet back in downward facing dog pose. And from here, we're going to come forward. Whether you jump or walk your way towards the front of your mat, come on into your standing forward bent. Get yourself easy with the placement of your feet. Feel your feet in the floor. And then let your hands rise on up to your hips and press into your feet as you come up to standing. And inhale your arms all the way out. Let them float up overhead. And as you exhale, let them come right down to rest right in front of your chest. Coming into your mountain pose, if you need to adjust around a little bit to get really balanced in your mountain pose, you. And just imagine you're looking out towards the horizon. Let yourself feel that sense of as though you were out all alone in a big empty field. And then we'll go ahead and unfold our arms on the down. Again, move whatever you need to move. We're going to come over to a wall, so take your time, bring your mat on into the wall. Side of your thigh for tree pose. And if you don't do it. You know, if you're like, yeah, no, I am not from here going into tree up high. I want to put my foot back down into my hat. And then just play here. Let yourself bring your gaze forward. If you want to keep holding the wall, because that's just what you need to do today, keep your hand on the wall. You can bring your arms up overhead if you want. You can keep your hands at your heart. Start to fall, put your foot down, readjust if you want. Find that focal point for yourself. Nice. And then go ahead and let yourself release. And come on down, turn to face the wall. And curl your left toes, if you can, up the wall. Keep your right heel on the floor in a really little mini lunge, okay? And the heel is directly behind your foot. And then bend your left knee into the wall. Now you can make a little pillow with your hands and rest your head on your hands and look down. Let yourself engage your belly. And if you don't feel anything in your calf, you might need to get a little longer stance, right? Sometimes though, just zipping up the belly gives you a really nice stretch there in your calf. And your Achilles too. One more breath. And then we're going to go ahead and push away from the wall and turn with our left hand towards the wall. Standing on your left foot, bring your right foot into your inner calf for a second. You can keep your hand on the wall, that's fine. You don't have to if you don't want to. You're really balanced, you don't need it, don't do it. And then separate your foot from your leg, let your right hand draw your right knee up and kind of towards your shoulder a little bit. And then you can reach down and get the inside of the top of your ankle and bring that foot to the inside of your inner thigh up high as you can if you want. And then if you're like, no, my hip doesn't like that, don't do it. Put the foot back down into your calf. And then start to play a little bit with your balance. Whether you'd like to keep your hands at your heart or you'd like to bring your arms up overhead. You know, or some of you may even want to put your hands behind you in tree pose. Remember, even trees sway in the wind. There's a movement of tree. When you're ready to come down, we're going to turn to face the wall again. We're going to curl our right toes if we can, or just put the tips of your toes at the wall. Step that left foot back like you're in a really mini lunge, so that when you bend that right knee, you can put your hands to make a pillow, kind of look down, or let your forehead be on your hands. Do what feels good for your neck, in other words. And then zip up your belly. Feel like you're drawing your hip pointer bones towards each other. Good. And then let yourself release and come on away from the wall and move around a little bit. Let your hips circle if you can. So if you can let yourself just circle around with the hips a little bit. And like a big hula hoop, but you know, obviously not going really fast enough. Besides, hula hoops don't work anymore. Do you
notice that?
Yes. So it's the hula hoop. It's the hula hoop fault. We're going to come down to the floor.
It's like
a gravity change.
I still have some at the house. I've got four, but that's like, all work.
It's not me, it's me. They must have changed the way that they did. So if you can come into a forearm plank with your heels up the wall, have fun with that. Yeah? Because it feels really good. And it's a really nice way to engage. You can even lift one foot up and put it on the wall. Put the ball of the foot on the wall and press into the heel that's on the wall of the other foot that's down on the floor. Oh my God, it's really intense. You don't have to do that one. Whoa. One leg feels kind of good. The other one, I would say not so good. And then let yourself release and come on down. We're going to shift back and we're going to come into child's pose if we can. Let our arms stay overhead. Let yourself release the back, release the hips. And if you're okay to come into dog with your heels up the wall, come on forward and come on into dog with heels up the wall. If you know you'd rather go right to your forearms, feel free to do that. You can play with a leg up the wall, whether you're on your hands or your forearms. You can play a little bit with one leg coming up at a time. Or, of course, I know a lot of you are probably already up with two. Well, I'll come down and I'll see you're already walking up the ball. So, you do what feels good. And if you don't want to be inverted, don't do it, you know. Or if you want to turn around and lie with your legs up the wall, you can turn and just put your feet up the wall, have your bottom kind of close to the wall. And you can also do these and then rest when you want, right? So if you decide you need to rest, let yourself come down and rest. Like with your toes, tips of your toes on the floor or toes curled under if you're on a blanket. I don't like to do it on the floor. Or you can have the tops of the feet flat on the floor. If you're okay just to be up like this on your knees, like you're standing on your knees and that's enough, do it. If you know you'd rather stand up to even think about like coming back here into a little bit of that, then you can stand up. It does feel very different when you're standing up than when you're on your knees for camera. So Me, I'm not a camel, natural camel poser. It is, I do like to practice, but man, I've got a long way to go. So, you know, I know a lot of you, this feels just great. You can come all the way, maybe even put your head in the wall, bring your hands down and hold on to your ankles and not even be at the wall, you know. So if camel is like to you the best thing ever, go for it. You can go as deeply into it or not deeply into it anymore. If your neck bothers you, the good thing about this is that you can maybe get your head to the wall, kind of send your hips forward, and you get this huge, huge stretch in your thighs, right, in the fronts of your legs, and also here in the front of your hips. It's a pretty intense backwards, however. Good. And when you're ready, come forward to give yourself a break, okay? Let yourself just come into child's pose for a breath or two. You can stay up with your hips, you know. Sometimes, if not only because you can't go, you know, not necessarily that you can't go back with your hips to your heels, but if you keep your hips up and kind of stay up and then go back a little bit, that's a totally different feeling than letting yourself go all the way back to your heels with your hips. And it can feel kind of good. It's not like you're doing less than a child's pose, is what I'm saying. It's a different feeling release. Good. And from here, we're going to come on up, and we're going to come to sitting. So if you think you'd rather sit on a blanket, do. We're going to bring our legs on around in front of us, shake them out a little bit. And we've got to do our thighs. Let's just do one thing before we come down on our backs. Let's take our right leg. Take your right leg. You can fold your left leg under you, or you can have it long, right? It can be low. So if you know, wow, the best I can do right now is to cross right here and just stay right here, you might want to come forward a little bit. Some of you might be able to get the leg, though, and start to let your hands move the leg around. Only if you can do this. You can stir the pot. Let go of circles, you can make circles, but really it's your arms that are doing all this work. And then you can maybe rock the baby back and forth. And if you want to pull the leg in closer to you to do all these, you can. So and it depends on how you're doing your hips. If this feels really good up here into the outer thigh, you can do those. And then you can even, like, imagine you're kind of drawing your knee back towards the wall behind you. So your hand can kind of push your foot back a little bit. Oh, and this is the one, too, if you want to talk on the phone. Kind of fun. And then when you're ready, we're going to switch legs. So we're just trying to release the hip here. It's fine just to stay right here. Below your knee, if that's too much, at your ankle, let the hip release, pick up the leg if you want. The circle things, the stirring the pot is really your arms, remember, doing the work. So if you dropped your leg right now, it would just go kerplunk, right? Because your arms are actually doing this. Now that's hard to do. You have more, you're holding in your hip more than you realize. You can go both ways with those circles. I'd imagine you're really just letting go. And then you can do the rocking the baby. And again, if you want to pull the leg in closer to you, if you're built as such, if that works for you. There you go. You can draw the knee back too. That feels good. Kind of like you're drawing a bow and arrow. Like, oh, you're drawing it back. And then, of course, if you feel like you want to think about drawing your foot towards your face, which is a very different stretch for the hip. And then we're going to release and come over down. Bring your hands back behind you for a second. Actually, see if you can. You can use blocks if you want. You can go down onto your blocks on your forearms, or you can go down onto your forearms on the floor. You can put blocks on them if you want to be a little higher. Just let yourself open your chest that way. And if you're close enough to the wall, you can even let your head come back to the wall like this. It's a fish pose variation where you don't have your top of your head on the floor, right? But it still feels pretty good. If you want to go down and do full fish pose, you have my blessing. You can come all the way down and come to the top of your head. If you know fish pose, it's a good one for you. That doesn't bother me yet. Bless you. You know, the cotton ones are going crazy right now. And they're big animals for a lot of people. So when you're ready, you're going to have to scoot away from the wall so that you can lie all the way down on your back. Let your knees come on into your chest. Release the knees a little bit side to side. And then see if you can come up and do a little happy baby pose. Let yourself release. Whether you hold the back of your thighs in happy baby or maybe you like to reach up to your feet or your ankles. You can hold the insides of your feet or you can hold the outsides. You can, again, just put your hands on the back of your thighs from your outside of your legs if you want. And you can go side to side if it feels good. Nice. And then let's bring our feet down to the floor. Bring our arms out beside us. Cross our right thigh over our left thigh, woman cross-legged kind of style, right? Lift your hips up, shift them to the right a couple of inches, and let your knees come over to the left. Grab a block or a blanket if you don't want to let your legs descend to the floor, right? So that you can relax in this twist. I mean, if it feels good to bring your right arm up a little higher, I mean, you can bend the elbow and just let it come up a little higher if you want to. That is totally up to you. Just let it feel good. In other words, if you can get to that being supported at a place where you can totally release, you might feel almost like not necessarily popping in your spine, but just a feeling of more space and release coming into this home. One more breath. Now when you start to head back up, go ahead and uncross because you're going to really kind of want to put your feet down and straighten out your spine. So you lift up and straighten out before you bring in left thigh on top of the right. Lift your hips, shift them to the left a couple of 3 inches and put them down. And then let your knees come over to the right. And again, if you feel like you get to this spot where, oh my gosh, I just can't go any farther, but you're hanging and you don't feel comfortable, that's when support is really handy, right? Because you might feel this pretty deeply up into your buttocks. You may feel, like I said, this kind of almost releasing feeling in the spine. So just enjoy letting that twist help you feel really released. And when you feel ready to come back up, you know, you take your time, and again, you uncross. So you can stay a little longer, you can come on up. Once you get up, what does your body want to do? Like, it could be any number of things that you want to do right now. You may decide that you feel like you want to bring your knees to your chest. You may decide something else. I'm going to start to walk around and I need a sign for any kind of support you need. So if you need a bolster, wave at me. You will. I'm not here. You want a bolster on your knees? You're going to go out the side. So let me know if a blanket or a bolster sounds like a good idea. Let yourself enjoy feeling the ground supporting you. You can kind of wiggle your way into shavasana. Your mind wanders away from your brain. breath, which it always does. Just see if you can bring yourself easily back to your breath. And just kind of come back to the breath again, and the mind becomes calmer again, and then before you know it, you're thinking again. And you just refocus back again to the breath. So just, there's no judgment. Let yourself really easily keep coming back to your breath. Feel how your body is responding to your breath. Maybe imagine yourself releasing even deeper in those little spaces between your breaths. Yourself in this 2 minutes to completely and fully relax. Thank you. comfortable for your hips. You can grab a blanket and sit on it, or a bolster, or let your legs stretch out if you need to. Just however feels really easy in your hips. So you can lengthen up through the top of your head and feel space in your spine. Feel your head floating up there on top. Each one of you a very joyful day. Namaste.
Namaste.